Hi, good morning. My name is Ron Tom, and I'm one of the co-chairs of the summer school this year. And on behalf of the Director of the Institute, Yehua Chu, and the organizing committee, we welcome you to Taipei and Asia A. This school is the 14th in a series that has been hosted by Asia A. And the theme of this year's school is astrostatistics and big data. This is a new, rapidly developing field, which is at the crossroads of statistics, computer science, information science, and astronomy. So the lecturers will address the methodological and technological challenges posed by the massive data sets from new generations of telescopes and observatories. We have seven lecturers, which come from all over the world, and the organizing committee has put together a really exciting program. But before we begin with the formal program, I'd like to introduce Yanting Lin from AJA, who will just give a brief overview of Tiara at AJA and some logistics of the school. Yanting.
Thank you, Rob. Hi, my name is Yanting Lin. I'm an associate research fellow at AJA. Welcome to the summer school. So let me briefly introduce our institute. Institute of Astronomy and Astrophysics, Academia Sinica, is better known as Asia A. This is our building. Academia Sinica is the leading research organization in Taiwan, and it has about 30 research institutes and centers, and Asia A is one of them. We are the largest astronomical research institute in this island. We have about 40 faculty members and 40 postdocs, among which about one-third are foreigners or non-Taiwanese. And so for this international setting, English is our working language. For our researchers, our interests span from star and planet formation, dust and interstellar medium, galaxy formation, galaxy clusters, weak lensing study of the universe, supermassive black holes, as well as our own solar system. All this research is conducted with forefront observing facilities, including OMA, SMA, JCMP, CVHT, and Subaru, etc. And in addition, Tiara is our theoretical division, which I'll come in a minute. And we also have excellent instrumentation labs, which contribute significantly to instrumentation for OMA, SMA, CVHT, Subaru. So TIARA stands for Theoretical Institute for Advanced Research in Astrophysics. It was established in 2004 to provide integrated program of research and education in theoretical astrophysics. The goal of the institute is to facilitate collaboration and training throughout Taiwan and Asia via schools, workshops, and a visitor program. The research is focused on astrophysics of the structures in the universe, particularly on the molecular clouds, ISM, and galaxies. As Ron said, the current school is the 14th in the series, following the summer school in radio astronomy last year, numerical astrophysics in 2015, and the school on cosmology back in 2014. It's worth noting that this one is the largest in terms of attendance. We have 80 students. About half of them are from outside of Taiwan, coming from 15 countries over three continents. So welcome. The primary motivation for us to hold this summer school is not only to educate students, but also to prepare ourselves for the upcoming tides of big data. I will just mention two examples of big surveys that AJA is involved. So the first one is Subaru Hypersupply Camp survey. We have participated in the construction of a new facility Subaru and HSC, which sits at the prime focus of the telescope, gives a very large field of view, the largest among 8 to 10 meter telescopes. And so with this powerful machine, astronomers from Japan, Taiwan, and Princeton University are conducting a big survey of the extragalactic sky, trying to understand the nature of dark energy, dark matter, galaxy formation, and the reionization epoch of the universe. You can think of this as a precursor to the incoming Large Synoptic Survey Telescope, LSST. And indeed, we are kind of struggling with the huge data amount coming from the survey. In the end, the data will exceed 1 terabyte. Sorry, 1 petabyte. So we need to know how to best extract information from this vast amount of data. Another example is TELS-2, which stands for Transmit Neptunian Automated Occultation Survey. The primary goal is to measure the size distribution of small hyperbaric objects in the solar system, because the nature of these objects will allow us to understand better the origin of the solar system. And the way we do it is to have 3 1.3 meter telescopes in San Pedro Mártir in Baja California in Mexico. Because these small objects are too faint to be directly observed, so we use the occultation technique to detect them. That is, when a small object passes through the line of sight to a distant star, the starlight will be dimmed a little bit. And if all three telescopes detect the same dimming, then we are sure that this is a real event. So from the statistics of this dimming, we can infer the size distribution of KBOs. The data amount is expected to be 300 terabyte of raw data per year. So this is also a huge data task. And that's why we want to be prepared by this summer school. We have a great lineup of lecturers. I will briefly introduce them now. Professor Jogesh Babu from Penn State University. Could you please stand up? He is the director of Center for Astrostatistics. In fact, he coined the term astrostatistics, and he's the author of this book, Modern Statistical Methods for Astronomy with R Applications. I will ask him to sign this book later. So he will give lectures on probability and model fitting, bootstrap model selection today and tomorrow. And the next is Yanqi Chen from University of Washington. Please stand up. He's a young assistant professor at UW, working at the intersection of astronomy and statistics, especially large-scale structure. He will tell us about statistical inference, regression analysis, and density estimation. And he will also give a tutorial on R, which is like the standard tool used by statisticians. And next is Professor George Jagowski from Caltech, please. He's the chair of the astronomy department at Caltech and the director of Center for Data-Driven Discoveries. He works on large-scale structure, galaxy formation, gamma ray bursts, many different fields in extragalactic astronomy. His lectures are on astroinformatics and virtual observatory, as well as classification challenges in time domain astronomy. And on Wednesday, he will also give a colloquium at HIA to be held here. The next one is Boris Leistet of New York University. Boris. He's an Einstein Fellow at NYU, working on many different fields, like cosmology, CMB, galactic structure, so you can ask him all kinds of questions. He will tell... Sorry. His lectures are on hierarchical Bayesian inference with applications and machine learning. And then next is Robert Lupton. He's a senior researcher at Princeton University. He's the mastermind behind the data reduction pipeline of Sloan Digital Sky Survey. So if you use Sloan data, you owe a lot to Robert. And he's also the driving figure behind the data reduction pipeline for Hyperspectral Cancer Survey, as well as LSST. And he's also the author of this book, Statistics in Theory and Practice. Again, I will ask him to sign this. Our next lecturer is Anna Skate from University of Manchester. She works on clusters and dust and many other things. Is the head of Center for Interferometry at the of Excellence at the University of Manchester, and she is deeply involved in the data reduction package for SKA. And she will tell us about fundamentals of radio imaging and machine learning, and on Friday, also a tutorial on Python for data analysis. And our last lecturer, who is not here yet, is Dr. Du Yiping from Academia Sinica. She is a research fellow and the vice director of the Institute for Statistical Sciences there. She will tell us about support vector machine later today. So this is all lecturers. And let me give you some logistic information. So as this school is primarily for students, so please come forward, sitting in the front. I mean it. So please do so when you have a chance. For Wi-Fi, at the back of your name tag, you can find information on how to connect to our network. Let me know if you have any difficulties. The design of this auditorium restricts our capability of providing a lot of power outlets. But we do have a charging station at the back of the auditorium. So please use that for charging your laptops. But don't overuse, otherwise the whole building will not into trouble. And perhaps most importantly, no food and drink allowed in this auditorium. The water is okay. Presumably in bottle form. If you feel the temperature is too low, too cold, please let me know and we will adjust it for you. As for restrooms, there are two restrooms, one on the E1 floor. You can get to it by going through this door in the front, turn left. Or the one on the first floor, you go out of the back entrance, turn left, and walk along the hallway, you'll find it on your left-hand side. As for lunch, please wear your name tags at all times. This will allow you to get the lunchbox. You can have lunch outside of the auditorium. We have some tables there. Or go to rooms on the 11th floor. We have a kitchenette and two similar rooms that can be used for lunch. You can just take the elevators to the 11th floor. Or you can use 1203. Since you cannot directly access to the first floor, you have to go to the 11th and then walk upstairs. We will have a banquet on Wednesday evening. The details will be given later. In case you didn't sign up for a lunchbox and you need extra food, this is the map of the campus. We are here. This is the Drunken Moon Lake. You can find shops here close to the library, or in B1 of this College of Social Sciences, or there are lots of restaurants targeting students. And then we have this needless lectures sessions. We have two sessions, because there are too many students. So one in on Tuesday afternoon and the other right after lunch on Wednesday. Two rooms are reserved for these sessions, both this auditorium and our room 1203. So the arrangement is the following. I think on your name tag, you'll find numbers, right? Okay. So for students 1 to 40, please sit in the auditorium for the first session, and then go to 1203 on Wednesday. For number 41 to 80, please do the opposite. So go to 1203 on Tuesday and stay here on Wednesday. And finally, if you need any help, just look for people with pink name tags. That includes all of us in the organizing committee and our able front office staff, Cindy, Shirley, and Grace. I think you have met them already. Or ask any students from National Taiwan University for local information. I think that's it. Thank you.